Tell you more about the game's like basics? Absolutely. I thought you'd never ask. So, this is an end game picture. Let's have a quick look at what it might look like at the beginning of a game. Good game. Kyrian, was that you that we were just playing? Good game. I was just lamenting how Cariarchs is seems like the thing of the past, and it was like, well, can we make it work? And evidently we can, but it was a hard fought win. You like it was a good game. It's a good game. Hard to do. Salty, you lost to the Cariarchs. So this is the basics guy, the most basic, so basic. He got to make the basic game guide for DreamHack. Yes, I can at least admit that I am that basic. But yeah, actually, I did make some. I have a. Actually, if you scroll up ever so slightly, the bot has a link to my YouTube where I've made some tutorial videos. Actually, one of them was used at DreamHack. But if I were to look at a solo game, just go to a practice game against an AI here, insane AI. We're not gonna play the full thing. We'll surrender. It'll be awful. I'll lose combat power. So the game is an auto battler. First and foremost, basics of the game. It is an auto battler game. That means let's not do elite. We're gonna just do something where it doesn't really change how the board looks. That means once the game gets going, even though it looks like a RTS, a real-time strategy game like StarCraft, it is not. Your interaction is here during this phase, the planning phase. When we hit end deployment, it will go into phase two where the game plays it out before us, and we'll see both you and your opponent will find out what's going on. You can see there's a fog of war here. I can't tell what the bot is going to where they're going to build things, but I do know what they started with. And this is interesting because each round you get a number of deploys that you can add on to the board each round, but the units from the previous round cannot move. So I will know when he places these next round, we'll know where they are, and they stay there for the rest of the game, so we can react to his plays, but we don't know what's going on at this current turn. So you get some information, but not all information. So I'm going to move my stuff. He knows what I started with too. Different units have different advantages. I'm not going to go through every unit, but we do have an artillery. The artillery is very powerful against slow-moving units, and he has fast-moving units, so the artillery is not good here. We also have the arc light, which is good against, it has a splash attack. It's going to be fairly good against the crawlers, one of the best, in fact, against the crawlers there. But he can't shoot air. He has air units as well, so we have a problem. The problem is, we need to be able to shoot up. So this is where the new deploys are coming in. We can, each round, you can unlock one new unit type. That's going to be this right here. We've got 20 different units available. We started with two from our starter pack. We can select ones that shoot air units as well. See, it has target air and ground kind of in the mid part of that text box there. I can't move my mouse to show you. After underneath the cost, targets air and ground. This one targets air and ground as well. The difference between these two, they also are free to unlock. A few of these are free to unlock. The larger units cost supply. I have 200 supply. Each round, this will go up. The larger units cost more. So the free units, I can do a sniper, self-explanatory, it's a sniper, or I can do a fang. This is a large quantity unit. We call it a chaff unit. There are 18 of them in the group. They do small damage individually, but one of their main advantages is there's a lot of them. And so the Phoenix here, which is kind of like an air sniper unit, the Phoenix will take, and it's fire slow, it will take a while to kill all the fangs. So let's try that. So we're gonna unlock it. That's our one unlock, and now we have two deploys. This squad thing here allows me to deploy two units a turn. I have 200. This costs 100. One, two. I got two deploys. I can place them, but I won't be able to move them after this round. Once I place them, they're locked in. Middle mouse button lets me alternate horizontal, vertical. And the thought is, by placing them in front of these will be chaff to protect my arc lights from his sniper Phoenix, while at the same time, hopefully, be able to shoot the Phoenix. And the arc lights will hopefully protect the chaff from the crawlers. The fangs will die to the crawlers. The downside is he's going to buy two extra units too. We'll see what he does. Or T to, oh yeah, there's hotkeys as well. Okay, he bought his own arc lights. That is bad news for us. The arc lights will clear out our fangs before the fangs can clear the air. We are going to be left without anything that can shoot up. We will lose the round. But I'm not playing this right now. This is where the auto battler kicks in. A major, major part of this game is not just what you choose to purchase, but where you place them. Where you place them. So we lost the round because we didn't have anything else to shoot the air. We are going to fix that. But then we also want to consider where to put our units. Ah. Between rounds, the game will offer various upgrades, or, in this case, free units to give you to augment your army. Now, your choices are exactly the same as your opponent's. So my opponent is choosing one of these. We have to choose something. So I can get a Fire Badger, which is a flame-throwing tank, a Typhoon, which is a rapid-fire, fairly short-range, little walker guy, Mustang. These are very similar. The Mustang's also rapid-fire. They both can shoot air, but this is long-range, much more of a glass cannon. And then you have a heavy artillery-type Scorpion here. Because we want to shoot air units, it's going to be one of these two. The Typhoon and the Fire Badger are of a special rare type. You can only get these in the cards. You can't get them normally. Let's go ahead and pick, just because it's a standard unit, let's go ahead and pick up the Mustang. It's a level 2 Mustang, and it costs us a little bit to get that. It costs us 100 to get that. But because it's level 2, it's doing more damage. Your units get experience, so I got a tiny bit of experience here. A little bit more experience as they go, when you can level them up, and they are more effective in combat. You also have techs. So I could potentially add range enhancement onto this Mustang, giving it extra range to help fight stuff. And maybe we want to, but that's 300. I only have 300. If we do so, that's all we get. So instead, let's buy another Mustang. And with our final purchase, let's unlock a crawler. I mentioned positioning. This crawler, we can put in all sorts of interesting places. Okay, I can put it way up front. This is a fast-moving unit, so it would charge forward and engage with this right away. It would, because it's the closest, everything targets by proximity. All of these things would focus in towards the center, and I would actually pull his entire army to the center. Maybe that's something I want. I might have artillery waiting for that. Or we could place it way in the background, so that after everything's engaged, the crawlers show up and maybe get his tower or something. These towers are targets of opportunity. If the tower dies, a debuff will hit the whole enemy force, and they will be, they'll take more damage, deal less damage, move slower. Furthermore, we could actually enhance our ability to get that tower by utilizing the flanks. From round 2 onwards, you can play in the flank, which is what we're going to do. And I'm going to place this here, and we're going to attack this tower. Likely, it's going to actually pull some of his guys. I don't know for sure. But by proximity, these guys might turn around. At least the Phoenix will. But the goal is going to be to go in there, grab that tower kill, and then buy everything else time. Let's see what happens. He picked up the Mustang as well. He placed it in the middle. Looks like everything's moving forward while we get summoned in, so we're going to have a free shot at that tower in the background. Meanwhile, we just hope that our units kind of hold the line. So you can see the daka-daka of those Mustangs shooting each other. The artillery taking out a swath of those Mustangs, and now the crawlers have arrived. The tower goes down, and a debuff hits the enemy. They're slower, they're doing 90% less damage, and they take more damage, so we're getting an opportunity to sweep them. It lasts, the debuff lasts for 9 seconds, so it's over now, but now it was enough. Can you play the game against real players? My friend, that is the whole point. I'm playing against bot right now. This is a great way to start out, so you're kind of more comfortable in that setting, but this is a PvP game first and foremost. And so there's a ladder. Anyone that you see streaming it, we're playing on the ladder. We're enjoying it. I'm just kind of being able to do this to take my time to explain a bit. Just because you asked. I enjoy it. Now, last round, we had units to pick from. Now we have specials to pick from. These are passive upgrades. So we could passively give all of our units extra move speed, which is pretty nice. We could get an ability. This is a cooldown ability. We'd have to do this every other round, not every round. Cooldown one round. Instantly gives XP for them to level up. So we could, if we get this, it costs 50, this one costs 100. We could instantly say level up this Mustang to level 3, which is, by the way, an awesome thing to do. Now he's halfway to level 3 already. We could potentially do this one and get him to level 2, because he has farther to go. Or we could just say upgrade our crawler there. I think the Mustang's a better idea. Deployment Specialist would let us get 3 units instead of 2 per round. That's also not bad. Or we can permanently change how our Scorpions function, which is a specific unit that I'm not buying. But it would give them attack, hit points, extra range, and increase their cost. I like the intensive training idea. Let's do that, and let's actually... This side seemed a little bit more in trouble, seemed a little weaker. I'm gonna upgrade it. It costs half of the unit cost to get the upgrade, but I think it's worth it. So we went ahead and got that upgrade. We're looking at the board, though. This is a lot of small, fast units. We need to deal with that. So let's get ourselves another Arclight to attack them. And let's get another crawler. And I'm going to do this, something's interesting here. I'm going to place this crawler behind my tower. The tower is a solid unit, which means the crawlers are going to split some of them to the left, the majority to the right, but they're going to split up beside that, which means by splitting, the splash of the Arclight is less effective. So we're going to split them up. Now, you could potentially maximize the split by going vertically like this. And you'd have more units split from each other. But the problem with this is if somebody were to flank you, like what I have right here, if this was behind her, 100% of the group will go and fight that group. And maybe that's exactly what they want. And I don't want to give them that option. So if I do this, only half the group will go and fight that. So that's why we do that. And let's go ahead and upgrade you. And your towers also have special powers. So the towers can give passive upgrades to your attack and your health. This tower is temporary powers for this round only, like extra range, extra speed. I'm going to get an extra deploy this turn. Just for this turn, an extra deploy. And let's go ahead and get another crawler for this side. The extra 50, let's go ahead and spend that too, just because we're showing the game. We can use devices. There are shields you can get, which is a 40,000 health shield that you can protect an area with. You can intercept missiles. We've got a missile firing Stormcaller. Let's do our own missile and just take out. This is a one-time thing, but it's going to take out that group. And then we see what the opponent did. The opponent actually made those crawlers even scarier. They have a new tech for Replicate. If they make a kill, they will get to produce another crawler from that kill. So it's all the more important that we eliminate those crawlers. Meanwhile, the AI is not smart enough to deal with our flank, so we're just going to flank him every turn. Also, for funsies, the AI has built a hacker. So he can hack one unit at a time. He's currently hacking one of my chaff and dying in the process. Hackers are great against large units, medium units, but not chaff. There is a training ground to learn these things. You can actually, you can customize a battle and just play it out round after round. I just wanted to kind of have a game to play against as well. Let's do the javelin now, guys, just to kind of show off. There's some things we could choose. Deployment again. This again, extra deploy every round. Junior, this means anything that's not a giant unit would be cheaper. This is not bad this early in the game. It's round 4. That's fairly early. We would get good value, but it costs 300 up front. So you'd have to deploy 6 units to get your money back. But for fun, we're grabbing that javelin. So what this means is we now have a cooldown that I can use somewhere on the map that will do 70,000 damage to everything stuck in the middle. So that means I could take out this, but he's splitting up. Let's grab this. And I'm going to put it a little bit forward because these Mustangs are not slow. This takes them a second to deploy. The Mustangs should be about mid or even slightly past halfway, you know, by the time that lands. So we should be able to take out both the Hacker and the Mustangs. Normally you reserve that to kill a giant. That's okay. It's fun. Yeah, you can javelin your own guys. Very helpful. Good input there. Thank you. All right, so we've got a few more upgrades because, again, I want to make sure he doesn't get to reproduce those crawlers. So we've got, these are crawler killing units. Let's get a little bit more chaff just to protect our Arclights. I don't want to give him too much to reproduce off of. But what also could be interesting, if I place this forward, we're going to pull everything centrally because, again, it's targeting by proximity. So if we do that, the next round when I get range on these Arclights, all of the stuff will just walk right into a kind of a kill zone right there. So let's see how that goes. Oh, he placed a shield, but our javelin does not care. There it is. We just took out that whole group. He did make another hacker. It's actually a shield from the hacker itself. Our crawlers are once again getting through. When the round is over, the surviving units, their total value in supply, so that, you know, like this this Arclight, he costs 100. If he's alive at the end of the round, he will deal 100 damage because of his cost. He'll do 100 damage to the bot. Each one of those dots is some, you know, it's them doing their damage there. This is the insane bot AI, by the way. It needs some help. Okay, let's actually pick the Typhoon because it's a rare unit, right? Or we could do the Sabertooth. No, let's do the Typhoon because we'll actually use it. So Sabertooth and Typhoon, and earlier we saw the Fire Badger, those are currently the three rare units. There are plans for more. Rare units, you can only get these through the cards. I cannot unlock them manually. They're calling those core units. These are rare. We're gonna grab the Typhoon. It's a cool looking unit. He does a walker thing. He acts very similarly to the Mustang. Low damage, high fire rate. There's two of them. They have different upgrades. And so he has an upgrade that's pretty fun. He can get a barrier, which puts a shield bubble around him, kind of like this has. Different radius. He also can get a mech rage, which is probably just what I'm going to pick here. It'll help him kill everything faster. Not that we really need the help. Or we could do the homing missile, which actually that's probably the most fun. Let's click the homing missile. So homing missile only hits ground. You wouldn't think so, but it only hits ground units. It fires four missiles. They deal 675 damage per level at a range of 180 meters, minimum of 60. So it's level 3. This is a level 3 unit. So we're actually multiplying that by 3. We're doing close to 2,000 damage per missile. Four of them, 8,000 damage. And it's a fairly long range attack. And just for fun, let's make that even stronger. And sure, let's get range here. We're going to go ahead and take out a loan. That's a temporary thing there. And then we're going to, oh, I don't know. Let's just get another crawler. A lot of times, just to demonstrate, you do want to protect your own flanks. So this is a decent thing to do, just throw a crawler here, having a Mustang to support it. That's a decent idea. Let's get temporary range. This is a solid thing you want to click towards the end of a match. You want to click the extra range and possibly the extra speed. These things, if you click it and your opponent doesn't, it changes the whole dynamic of how the fight plays out. There's that extra missile that we have. They're not particularly great against Chaff. I mean, they kill them, but Chaff is... They're all about taking, you know, dying instead of something else. But they'll fire again. Oh, that's right. I forgot. He's got anti-missiles on his Mustang, so he's trying to shoot those down. Whatever. It's fine. So... This should be the end of the match, and hopefully that was a good crash course on the game. It feels like chess when you're playing against a real opponent, because you can kind of see what they've played last round, you're playing your round, you're reacting to their turns. We often compare it to chess. So again, we can just look at the battlefield here. We didn't know what he was putting down new each round, but once this stuff is here, it's here to stay. There are a few units that have a special power that let them move. I don't know if we have any on the board right now. But there are a few, mostly their air units, that can do that. Outside of a match, you can actually adjust which technologies are available for your units. Which makes it really fun in a metagame sense. Because as you're playing the game, you level up here. This is not pay to win. It just means you put a little bit of time into the game. You get tech points. Those tech points mean that you can go to your units and unlock other techs. So right now, our crawler has four techs equipped. There are five total available. You will start with Acid Explosion. You'll have the first four. I have unlocked Impact Drill, unequipped Acid Explosion, and added Impact Drill onto it. So that's how my crawler is built. But you don't have to do that. You can build them however you want. So you could do that. Acid Explosion makes these guys little bombs. Whenever they die, they leave a pile of acid, which does a health drain and also a debuff that makes them take more damage. Could be useful in a meta where war factories are everywhere. But right now, I like Impact Drill. It lets the crawlers be a threat. So, again, hopefully that was helpful to people. Never fear, you are always welcome to ask for any tips, any advice, anything at all. I love to teach. And I enjoy the game.